Hey friends, I'm Chris and I'm going to do a reading for February, so to see what the energies are like in the sacred feminine, sacred masculine grid for February. It's very intense energies as now we are approaching the full moon lunar eclipse tomorrow in Leo. So I'm going to use three decks today. I'm going to use the Wild Unknown Tarot, the Keepers of the Light, and Angel Answers. And then next week for Valentine's Day, I'm going to do an energy reading for romance for the year too. So I'm looking forward to that. So I'm going to start with the Wild Unknown Tarot. And so we are asking what the energies are for the sacred masculine, sacred feminine. This reading is particularly good for anyone that's, you know, really connecting to their soul purpose, or they're already on their soul purpose, on their path. So this is not like a conventional, you know, reading. Okay, so this card wants to pop out as... I think this is coming out for the Divine Masculine as the first card. So we're already in the beginning of February, so I think this is just reflecting energy that's already out there. It is the Six of Pentacles. So it's the Six of Earth. Sorry, I'm not used to using this, this camera on the phone. On the computer, I mean. So... for the Divine Masculine, this is about finding balance in love, and particularly the giving and receiving energy. It could also mean giving and receiving money and material resources. So in your life, you're feeling a balance of and a flow of give and take. Next card for the Masculine. You're going to pull three cards for Masculine, Feminine, and then for the unified energies. And you may find that, you know, since many of you are already really balanced, that you might resonate with cards on the feminine or masculine side, or both. And it doesn't matter what gender you are, right? So the more unified we get on the collective level, the more that the energies are going to feel more congruent to us and resonate with us. Okay, the second card for the Divine Masculine is the Seven of Wands. There we go. It's a really beautiful card. And what this is all about courage. Courage and speaking your truth. So it's saying, you know, you feel like you're battling something alone. And I think that is, you know, ultimately what we have to do. We have to stand on our own and illuminate our own path. And you can see all the other the branches have, you know, parted ways. So this is a full moon. So things will be illuminated. Truths will be revealed. And there's a lot of releasing. And sometimes that releasing, you know, requires a lot of courage. And I also know that when we see the number seven, that's basically a sign that, you know, the angels, God is telling you you're on the path, on the spiritual path, on the path you're supposed to be on. Okay, so the third card for the Divine Masculine. For the energies of February. So I feel like this is kind of for the end of February as we're getting into Pisces season, this next card. And that card is the Two of Swords. Interesting. And look at the look at that. Around February 26th, we're going to have... is it a solar eclipse or a lunar eclipse? I don't remember, but we have a new moon in Pisces, and it is an eclipse. So again, as of, you know, tomorrow, I think this is what we're seeing here for the divine masculine. We're seeing courage in standing up for your beliefs, and it's that full illumination, right, of the full moon. But look at this card here. So this one is a blacked out sun. So this is another eclipse. So this is the second eclipse, which is February 26th in Pisces. Having to make a decision, but either not having all the information, so you have to make a decision based on faith. You have to take a leap of faith and just let go. It looks like this month for the Divine Masculine is about really rooting into your balance. Right? And trusting. Because there's two eclipses this month. So it's major. The first eclipse is in Leo. So if you're a Leo, or, you know, no matter where a Leo is in your chart, you're going to feel it. But for those who are actually Leos, there's going to be a big release for you. And I think, again, Divine Masculine Leos, you have to let go. There's a really beautiful card in the Osho Zen Tarot deck where the same card is represented in a different picture, but the picture is so perfect for this. It's a man, there's like a chasm and then two mountains, and he's got his feet on one set of mountains and his arms on the other, and he's over the abyss, you know, this big drop, and basically he's trying to decide, should I let go with my hands and fall, or should I let go with my feet? Do I fall head first or feet first? It doesn't matter which way you let go, because you're not going to fall, you're going to fly. That's the message. So don't be afraid to let go and release something and set yourself free and make a decision. So I think come the end of February, if you're not ready to make that decision that you're thinking of now, by the end, you're gonna feel like you're between a rock and a hard place. You have to decide. Okay, Divine Feminines. For this time in February, what the energies are. Divine Feminine, we like to take our time a little bit here. Let's see if this one feels right. Ooh, yeah. The Hermit. So, Divine Feminines, you've been feeling like you're needing a lot of contemplation time, and time alone, time to reflect, and really to connect with your inner spiritual light. Look at the kind of the matchup here between the Divine Feminine and the Masculine, the flame. That it's all about the inner flame right now, and really connecting with your light so you can send it out into the world. Beautiful tortoise. I love tortoise energy. Okay, so that's your energy for right now, feminine. And then in the next 2 weeks, so after, this full moon, and two cards came flying out of the deck for Divine Feminine, the Father of Swords and the Nine of Cups. Interesting pairing. So emotional fulfillment, wishes fulfilled. So when you have the Nine of Cups, it means that you're really close to the end goal, and you feel that the wish that you've been wishing for is nearly here. So it's basically saying your wish is granted, just not quite yet. But the good thing is, when you get this card, it's all about imagining and celebrating what that would feel like if your wish was granted. So beautiful card. And then the card that came up with it is the Father of Swords. Actually, the Father of Swords came out first. The Father of Swords is a really great energy. It's mastery of the intellect, of rational decision making. So maybe what this is saying together is, you know, and I love the owl because he's so wise, right? Yeah, this guy is not a very warm and fuzzy character. But these are very warm and fuzzy feelings. So, air and water, combining and alchemizing emotion and intellect, rational thinking and intuitive thinking. It's saying that both of those faculties are going to be with you, and that's what you really need both for your wish to come true, for that which you've been wishing for, right? For that to manifest, that whatever it is that you have been working on. Okay, so for the end of the month for Divine Feminine, so who are the indecisive ones, the masculine or the feminine, right? I'm like, just the feminine, just like, keep shuffling. Not in a hurry. Okay. End of the month for the Divine Feminine is the Father of Cups. Beautiful. Swans in this deck represent love. And you got two kings here. So are there two men in your life that you have to choose between? Or, you know, from an energetic perspective, again, you had the King of Swords, so that's air, and King of Cups is water. This is a Pisces, Cancer, or Scorpio man. And also represents your energy, which is the mastery of the heart, mastery of love and emotion. So I feel like these are also saying that you're being very influenced right now by the Divine Masculine, maybe by his courage to stand up. And you're feeling these warm feelings towards him. Maybe it's about compassion towards the Divine Masculine. So if you've been feeling resentful about men or towards a particular man, it's saying have compassion for, you know, because we always think, you know, oh, I'm a woman, I'm going through all this stuff. And well, the guy's going through stuff too. He may not be showing it, or he may not be showing it in an emotional way, but believe me, he's feeling something. But this is a good sign for the feminine. She's in a real month of mastery. And again, if you're a masculine and you're feeling drawn to the feminine cards, it just means that you're really integrated with your feminine energy. Okay, so now I'm going to choose cards for this month that represent the union of masculine and feminine. So what, when we bring those energies together, what do they create? What alchemy is created here? Beginning of February. The Knight of Swords, also called the Sun of Swords. So this is the counterpart for, you know, the King of Swords. This is like the less mature version. This is the knight in shining armor that just rushes in to save the day. And he can be a little bit, I guess, brash. This is an air sign. You know, because swords are the mental air element. So Libra, Aquarius, and Gemini. I think what it means, though, is, I mean, look at how he's just like flying. He's so directed, and he's pointing that sword. He's got a place to go. He's got a goal. He's trying to reach a goal. So the collective energies, I feel like, are beginning to move faster in February towards a goal. And it's something about truth. What is the truth? And we know we're close to the truth, or we're flying straight towards it. Okay? And that's kind of, that card represents like February 1st to kind of the time we're in now. So this is probably something you're already feeling, that things are moving faster. Things are picking up speed from December and January. Okay, so starting tomorrow with the full moon eclipse in Leo through, so kind of basically mid-February. Okay. The sun. So the sun also in this deck represents the sign of Leo, and we're having a full moon eclipse in Leo. Leo represents the heart. So, you know, we've been flying towards the heart of the matter. So right in smack dab in the middle of February, we're dealing with the heart, with, again, illumination. So truth that's coming from the heart. And I feel like there's people who want to communicate this more, but again, I'm not seeing particular... I'm seeing the feminine possibly communicating. Father of Cups could definitely communicate from the heart very easily. Masculine has this card. And I feel like almost like it's cutting off. I don't feel like it's cutting off his heart. I feel like since this is air, I feel like this is cutting off his throat chakra. So he may not be like as ready as the feminine to express the truth that's in his heart. But he knows what it is. He knows what it is. Here it is. He knows exactly what it is. And for whatever reason, if there's somebody in your life that's either masculine or is carrying the divine masculine energy and you feel like you want to tell them the truth of your heart, I don't think it's not that he's not open, but I feel like the masculine might be more like still in kind of a hermit phase. Yeah, I'm not getting that. I'm getting that it would definitely warm him. It would make him happy because the sun is a really happy card. It's good health, vitality, happiness, wealth, good family, friends, all that good stuff. So that's the collective energies. That's what we're creating in unity. So at the end of the month around the Pisces new moon eclipse, what is the collective? What are we creating? Aha. The star. Beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. So, the star again, wishes fulfilled. So, we love that. We love that. Wishes fulfilled is also healing. So here, we have the sun in the middle of the month and the star at the end of the month, right? So again, we're seeing a lot of congruence here. We're going from the sun, which is more about the ego, the self, to the star, which also represents the sign of Aquarius. And that's, the star is about humanity, loving humanity, opening your heart to all of humanity, doing work that that brings equality to others, that brings hope. Hope is a big theme with the star. Hope, faith, optimism. So with this new moon in Pisces at the end of this month, we're going to have some really beautiful energies. Okay, so with that, I'm going to pull some clarifier cards from Kyle Gray's Keepers of the Light Oracle. And these are beautiful. These are ascended masters, archangels, different deities from all different cultures. It's a great deck. All right, so I really want clarification on the one card in the masculine for the end of February, the Two of Swords. So it's the card that represents the Pisces new moon eclipse. So what's going on with the divine masculine there? Beautiful. Hilarion, divine healing. There we go. Gorgeous card. Look at all that green heart chakra. I also feel like when we see this much green, it's about getting out in nature, healing in nature. It says, divine healing, honor your sensitivity, retreat to recharge and heal. Your light can support others. I feel like I need another card. What? That didn't quite answer my question, I don't think. But so at the end of the month, the masculine feels like he's in between a rock and a hard place, wanting to make a decision, probably about a communication. Something he wants to say that feels like he doesn't know how to say it or if he should say it. So something, he's going through a healing, a purging. Okay. Joan of Arc, voice of truth. Yes. Masculine, here's the card. Look at the sword right there. And it stops right at her throat chakra. And I love these beautiful lilies, the purity, you know. And she's also associated with Archangel Michael. Archangel Michael is the warrior angel who was guiding Joan of Arc to victory. And she was she was a teenager when she was leading battle against the English. They were fighting English domination. So stand strong, focus on your purpose, release the fear of persecution, and speak your truth. So yeah, we were talking about courage that you're going to be tapping into. Keep that courage light bright, even though you might feel at some point towards the end of the month that it's eclipsed. You might feel like, where did my courage go? What the hell happened? I don't feel, you know, as strong, or I don't feel as brave, or I don't feel as grounded. So get grounded and heal yourself, whatever that takes. Maybe body work, get some work done, get out in nature a lot. And then you're also being guided to speak your truth no matter what. Be brave, because whatever you have to share, it's going to bring blessings. Okay, so on the feminine side, I'm going to draw a clarifier card for these two cards that came up together, as I feel like this is the time we're in now, and there's some importance here. There's something important that we're learning and doing in the next 5 to 7 days. So I would love some clarification on that. Maybe you would too. Okay, so divine feminine, what are we really learning here during this full moon eclipse in Leo? What is this about? The Holy Spirit, expect miracles. Look at that. Gorgeous, 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 gorgeous. Mm-hmm. And we had the Nine of Cups. Look at that, the cup. Here's the Ace of Cups with wings, angel wings, the dove, like the communion wafer dove. Look at that. Holy Communion. Being in communion with your higher self, with God, with the Holy Spirit. So it doesn't matter what religion you are. You know when you're divinely connected, you feel, you get the chills, or you just feel very confident, but not like in, you know, not in like a big boastful way, but just like, you have that quiet knowing. So that's what this is about. And the Holy Spirit is, I would say, is a neutral to a masculine energy. Remember that only love is real. Miracles will occur naturally. Spirit has your back. Okay, another sign. What I talk about, when you want your wish to be fulfilled, you have to let go and trust and expect the best. Expect miracles. If you don't expect a miracle, it's not going to happen. That's just how it works. So stay in a state of positive expectation. Now, that doesn't mean that you can direct spirit and tell them, you know, what to give you. They're going to give you what you, probably what you need more than what you want. But whatever that is, it's going to be a miracle. But that doesn't mean, obviously, be clear on what you want. But, you know, no, I love Doreen Virtue uses the word outlining, where you're telling the angel step by step, you know, what you want and what you want to have happen. And I feel like a miracle is much better than anything that you can, you know, put on a to-do list and give to God and the angels. Just is, whatever they're going to bring you is better than what you expected to get. So expect the best. Expect a miracle. All right, so I'm going to use these cards next, called Angel Answers. These are so fun. Doreen Virtue and Radley Valentine. Okay, so what am I asking for here? Okay, so I want to pull a card for the about the Divine Masculine journey this month, February. See what the angels have to say. Within the next few months, look at this beautiful card. It's like a golden temple. And then it's got this gorgeous magenta curtain. Magenta represents manifestation. So, Divine Masculine, there's something that you're brewing up now that's really going to come to fruition within the next few months. So let me read the card. In the next few months, what you are asking about will occur. Divine timing means that other people's free will choices are also involved, so keep the faith while all of the pieces of this puzzle come together and the situation resolves itself beautifully. So whatever it is that you're facing that you need extra courage right now, it's going to be resolved in a very beautiful way. You're going to manifest something really beautiful. But it looks like it requires, the next few months requires healing and strengthening your courage to speak your truth. Because if you can't say it, you can't have it. I think that's what this is saying. You have to say it out loud somehow. You know, maybe you write it in a blog post, maybe you talk about it with a friend, or if there's someone that you need to have words with, then you make that happen. So beautiful. So the Divine Feminine, we want to know what our angels have to tell us about the energy of February and our journey through February. Although I'm feeling some ways more like I'm on the masculine side these days. I'm looking at the feminine side going, yes, yeah, some of that resonates, but I'm feeling some of that masculine needing more courage to speak up. So if you're a feminine and you're connecting to that message too, that's all good. Because some parts of this message may not resonate with you. None of it might, or some of it might. So don't just think because you're feminine or masculine that you have to stick to one side. Okay, so Divine Feminine. Oops, something popped out here. Ooh. Okay. Looks like the Divine Feminine is going through, this is probably what that Hermit card was about, recovery. And look at this beautiful gold. And then it's got this emerald green curtain. I'll try to hold it still. I'm sorry, I'm kind of shaky. And so there's, if you see, there's a woman here, and then there's either like angel or Jesus or some kind of healing being behind her, putting his hands like on her back. I think he's like doing some healing work on her. And her chest is really open and exposed. I feel like for the Divine Feminine, this is about healing your heart. That the angels are really helping you heal whatever aches and pains are there. And it could be also that you're coming out of a time where you're recovering from an addiction or an illness. So this is a great sign. So whatever this is going on for you in your journey for February, you're recovering. Let me read the message. This is a period of recovering and healing for you. The challenging emotions that you've been dealing with will fade away with time. Although it may be difficult to see now, there is a joyful future awaiting you. But for now, take all the time you need to regain your strength. This card also means that your recovery is nearly finished or already complete. Send words of gratitude to heaven and begin planning for the next exciting phase of your life. So yeah, I feel like if you've been weighed down with an illness or heartbreak, or healing your heart from past relationships, childhood issues, that I think that time is coming to an end and you're nearing the end of that healing journey. Beautiful. Okay, so I'm going to choose another Angel Answers card for the collective unified energies of Divine Masculine, Divine Feminine, to see what the angels have to say to kind of amplify the message for the month of February that we got. So what's our journey here in February? And there, you know, some of you might feel like that the reading or the cards for the unification of energies really spoke to you. I know that one felt really right on to me. Because we're always in co-creation with our higher self, with God. But I think right now on the planet, which is why I read Divine Masculine, Divine Feminine, outside of, you know, the regular romantic readings, which I'm going to start doing them, and I'm going to start the first one next week for, you know, around Valentine's Day. Okay, we've got two cards for unification. So, yeah, so the Divine Masculine and Feminine energies is really, to me, about the energies that are taking place on the planet, that we are integrating within ourselves the masculine, feminine energies, and then coming together with others. Interesting. So we got two cards out of the deck for the collective unified energies. Ask for help from others and reconsider. So this one, very beautiful. I love that. So this is about partnering up. May or may not be with your beloved. It might be with other like-minded friends or colleagues or family. But we've got a masculine and feminine together. Ask for help from others. That's pretty clear, but I will read the message. And then the other card is a Blu-ray card. It's Archangel Michael, and it says reconsider. Again, look at that sword here. But this one stops right at, like, just about the heart center. But he's lit up at his throat chakra and his third eye. Look at that. Get it closer. Beautiful message. So Blu-ray. The Blu-ray is presided by Archangel Michael. Okay, so ask others for help. I'm going to read that one first. It's not necessary to do everything on your own. Your angels are asking you to reach out to those around you for assistance. By allowing others to lend a hand, you greatly increase your chances for success, and your plans will begin to move forward. The help you receive may also include important information provided by knowledgeable individuals. The stress of doing too much can create both physical and emotional health challenges for you. Surround yourself with loving friends and family who are willing and able to lighten your load, and you'll begin to feel much better. So this again is reiterating that you are in a healing phase. So I'm not saying you're not strong, but you may not be quite, you know, in your full force life energy as maybe you think. So really focus on healing and asking for help. Because if you let yourself get overloaded, you cannot use these energies. I mean, the energy tomorrow of this full moon eclipse in Leo is all about heart healing. It's going to be a huge release, heart healing, if you can allow that. But if you're too busy running around and you can't stop and take a breather, look at the moon even, take a little moon bath, go to the ocean, go to a body of water, and just sit and meditate for a half hour. You know, just the minimum. If you don't have time to do any of the minimal kinds of things, that's a problem. And you need to look at that. So you're going to stifle your own healing if you don't ask for help. So lighten your load this month as much as you can. And that way you can journal, meditate, do yoga, focus on, you know, right nutrition, right body movement, it's connecting to spirit, doing ritual, whatever it is that you do. You really need to do that this month because it's a huge door opportunity. You need to walk through that door, and you're gonna be like this. You know? I mean, I know the angel said within the next few months. But really, anything can be healed at any moment. You don't have to wait a few months. You don't have to wait till tomorrow, right? Reconsider. Interesting card. Let's see what this one has to say. I think this is a message from Archangel Michael. There is an element of your plan that should be reevaluated. Take some time to really go through your project or proposal thoroughly. Share your intentions with a trusted friend or advisor who can give you objective feedback. Ask your angels for guidance. This is not the moment to make the change in your life that you're considering. A better time will come, or you'll realize that you wish to choose a different kind of transformation for yourself. Whoa. So, this just kind of came to me. Eclipses will take any situation and turn it on its head, like flip-flop. Like you were like, okay, let's say you, I haven't taken, you know, vacation in 20 years, which of course shouldn't never be the case, but maybe it is for some people. And you plan it, you buy the tickets. And then, you know, you're about to get ready, you're packing. And I don't know, something happens and you have to change your plans. So this is what I said about expecting a miracle, but not necessarily expecting what you think or what you imagine in your mind happening. Don't expect necessarily that to happen. This month is about change. So reconsider, doing over, consider. And he's lit up in the throat chakra and the third eye. And he's got a big blue gem right here. Blue is, you know, third eye. So you might already know what this is about. And you, part of you is like, well, I want to know how things are going to turn out. I want to know the exact right plan to take. And they're asking you to expect miracles, to let this step aside and let spirit kind of direct you step by step. I think this is also a sign that you're being protected. We're all being protected, right? I know this is not the year I had envisioned. I thought last year, you know, was the year of my separation, divorcing. And I thought that was hard. I thought this, you know, 2017 is going to be an easy year for me. And guess what? You know, a few weeks ago, my mom was diagnosed with stage 4 pancreatic cancer. and I was about to buy plane tickets to Iceland, France, and India in May, obviously. And I kept procrastinating. I kept feeling like, I don't think I should buy the tickets, but you know, here's a good deal. Why am I not wanting to do this? But something was nagging at me, don't buy the tickets. And then I found out about my mom and it's okay, it all makes sense. So right now you might be getting messages from Archangel Michael or your guides or ancestors to reconsider plans that maybe are really dear to your heart, that you've been planning since last year, that you've been planning for 20 years. If you feel hesitant about doing something, or you keep procrastinating about something, that's a sign. Listen to it. And I think what this is saying is with this eclipse season, you know, so tomorrow the full moon eclipse, something's going to come to light that's going to go, okay, now I know why I didn't feel like charging into this. Right? There's something that I didn't know, some piece of information. So you're going to get a new piece of information. You're being protected, so follow your guidance. And the same thing when we get the other eclipse for the new moon in Pisces, the end of February. Just really, okay, breathe and slow down. This is us in the beginning. This is how we've been most of this month, like flying towards a goal, like really driven, like I'm going to do this. I'm finally going to do this. But they're saying, maybe you won't be doing exactly that, or it might not be the right time. Okay. So nothing to be worried about. And then I forgot actually to get a clarification for the unified energies from the Keepers of the Light deck. So I'm going to choose one more card. Am I still recording here? Yep. I'm still recording. We're at 42 minutes. Holy cow. This is going on for a while. I feel like Spirit has much to tell us. Oh, and I also have my readings up on my website. So, I have readings for general life purpose, for sacred partnerships and romance, and for business, like help with projects and different things. So if you go to chrisoster.com, K-R-I-S-O-S-T-E-R.com, you can look at my readings page and see what I have to offer if you'd like a personal reading. Yeah, might be a good idea. Oh, yes, we're going to have a month of roller coasters. Okay, so what is the collective unified sacred masculine, sacred feminine energy for February? Beautiful. Master Buddha, increased awareness. Beautiful. Look at him. Deep connection, trust your inner voice. Yep, that's the message here. Look how beautiful he is. So however you connect to your inner voice, you're being guided right now. We're all being guided. Nobody's alone. So even if you feel like, wow, I can't ask anybody for help, you definitely ask the angels for help. Ask your guides, and you can just say it in prayer. You can write it down on a piece of paper. This is what I need help with. Please give me a sign. Lead me step by step. Or what is the next step I need to take? Or you know what I mean? All of that, all of those answers are within you. And you might feel like, well, I'm hearing this voice in my head, but it's really my own voice. I'm imagining things. You're not. It is the inner voice of your divine presence. So I'm going to read this. Okay, so Buddha. So we, most of us know the story of Buddha, that he was actually a very wealthy prince. And then somehow he got out in the world and he saw suffering, saw people starving and dying and disease. And he was just like, his eyes were opened. And he became so compassionate and wanted to, you know, help others. And so he walked this path of service, like many of us do. So he left behind all earthly pleasures and sought enlightenment so that he could end suffering in the world. Now he helps us make contact with our inner teacher and encourages us to acknowledge how we feel and then accept it so that we can move beyond the suffering we feel. So don't suffer over your suffering. There's probably, you know, quite a few people suffering right now because of, you know, circumstances in their lives, political weirdness going on. There's all this stuff in the world, but really we're always connected to our inner teacher, our Buddha within. You are moving beyond the illusions that fear has created so that you can be more focused on your priorities and what is serving you on this path. All suffering eventually comes to an end, and acknowledging how you really feel and what occurred in order for you to feel this way will help you move beyond it. Call on Master Buddha now to help you remember you are part of something that is greater than suffering. The wheel of karma is turning in your favor, and all of your acts of kindness and goodness will benefit you. Thoughts may arise now that solve issues in your life, home, relationships, or work. They are being sent to you from your inner teacher, the Buddha within. So, gorgeous, gorgeous reading. I'm going to post this to my website. And always at the end of my readings, the dogs bark. They're like, yes. See? The little mutts. Have a beautiful February. I'll be back next week with Sacred Partnership Divine Love collective reading. And I hope this reading serves you and gives you peace, and know that you're protected, all is well. Okay, I love you. Bye.